from an undisclosed bunker deep in the earth, bringing you the best in horror, paranormal, and conspiracy. We welcome you to this week's Zombie Fight Club broadcast with your host, Eddie Rotten.
They want the major population centers wiped out so that the few that are left will be more easily controllable. 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 Controllable.
Wow. Hey. Thank you so much, everybody, for coming back to Zombie Life TV episode Who the F Knows. We have a huge show tonight with Brenda Dickerson. And he's going to go by Brenda tonight, but we have a whole lot of stuff to talk about. Like I say, every single episode, there's cons that we went to. I went to Granbury last weekend. Where were you at?
At home sleeping off a hangover.
Right on. Everybody's got them. Don't be ashamed. Don't be ashamed.
I'm not ashamed. That's why I said it.
Well, you were at Spider House Cafe.
Oh, man, that was... Dude, if you haven't met Cheetar, you haven't lived.
Pretty amazing,
if you haven't
right?
seen Blood Diner... As a horror fan,
yes.
You haven't fucking lived.
Well, it's an amazing event that RedRum went to,
yes.
And you were there too. Am I mistaken in saying that you were there?
I was there for the question and answer.
Oh, yeah. The Q&A,
and I got to meet Cheetar afterwards.
Okay, for those that don't know, explain Cheetar to us. What is Cheetar?
She was a solid gold, really hot looking woman.
Yeah,
and she actually touched her golden nipples against me. So,
oh, really?
Oh, yeah. I'm like, really?
Nice.
Golden nipples?
How could I have possibly?
So awesome. She was outstanding. She was dancing for us.
Did she
the,
was outstanding.
Did the tentacles from her belly touch you?
Oh,
yeah.
Man.
Oh, that's
so what?
Some good
she's
stuff,
incredible.
Man.
What was?
So Cheetar really is. I mean, you have to watch the movie. I'm not gonna spoil.
Blood Diner.
You have to watch the movie. To
classic
know who
among
she
classics.
Does.
Yes, and that was back like in the 70s or something.
No, it was 80s. 87.
87. Okay. Well, Red Rum did Cheetar and Blood Diner last weekend.
So much
I was
fun.
In Granbury doing the Granbury Paranormal Expo, and there
how
was
that?
It was cool, man. The thing was, there was a lot of people. It's a very conservative town. Like everything about it is conservative. And
so it was like a bunch of Baptists, and you guys were like trying to do.
Yeah, it was
kind of
like
shit.
That. People would walk by our booth and kind of give us a cringing look where their family was with them, and then their family would leave, dude. And then those people would come back and say, "I'm totally interested in your show.
I'm not with them.
Yeah, could you please tell me everything about it?" But I've got a whole lot of people that are watching the show tonight from Granbury, so thank you so much. And also people from Blood Diner, I'm sure.
Oh man, I mean, everybody at Blood Diner was, you know, were Austin horror fans.
I mean,
from
right,
you know, Austin Horror Society, Blood Over Texas, and everything like that.
Yes.
I mean, they were our people.
Yes,
basically. And it was, I mean, that's why I didn't think of it as like a con, because I wasn't there.
It was like a family reunion.
It was just like, yeah, man, I was with
my family
last
there.
Weekend.
Yeah.
What were you doing?
It was like a family reunion.
It was so awesome. I mean, Jackie Kong, the director of Blood Diner.
Yeah.
God, she's so amazing. I mean, down to earth, her daughter, Emma, was just amazing.
You were talking about her outside. Now, Emma is an artist, you said?
Yeah, she's a new upcoming artist. You know, she's been working on her own outside of her mom's kind of influence and stuff
right.
like that. But she's still with her mom and supports her mom. And so Emma's following Jackie around this entire time.
See, that's
at
that
Blood
family.
Diner
that's family.
And doing the whole Cheetar thing. And
very,
just,
very cool.
I mean, it was really awesome.
Very cool. What an experience.
Yeah, I felt bad about not bringing Dean.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
Well, we had a whole bunch of cons. We did two cons the weekend before. We did two cons last weekend. And today is very special to me because I've been wanting to have Brenda on since day one, since we had the TV show. And this you're an Austin icon. I don't know if you even consider yourself that, because you're just kind of doing your own thing. when I first met you, you didn't even know who I was, and I walked up to you at we were at a bar, and it was there was a mud wrestling event going on or something. There was like a Jello wrestling.
Yeah.
Why did you jump in?
We had the green slime.
A green slime. It was for like last
awesome night.
Last Halloween or the weekend or the Halloween before, I can't remember. But there was a dog running around. It was just like an amazing acid trip what it kind of was.
I got to pour the slime down women's cleavage.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
Yeah, very awesome.
While they screamed.
Okay, so I definitely need to borrow your boots now.
Yeah. Yeah. When you showed up tonight, you did not disappoint. You have the full outfit on. You've got it's not called stilettos. These are more like kiss boots, like snow boots almost, that have like handcuffs on them and chains on them, and your whole outfit and everything just screams Austin. And I just want to spend some time digging into you, getting inside you.
Whoa. Really? Getting inside you. Seriously?
I want to
make the sunglasses off.
I want to make it entertaining, and I've got the sunglasses on because these lights are so bright, and I think it's kind of working for me. And I wanted to apologize real fast. I've got a loose tooth, okay?
Oh, gross.
In my adult years, I've got a loose tooth. You know what my son told me? He's like, that's awesome because the tooth fairy is going to come to you and you're going to get some money for it.
I would love to see what the tooth fairy looks like for you.
Yeah, the tooth fairy is going to come to me and be like, you are such an asshole for not taking care of your teeth. So if I accidentally spit a tooth in your forehead, it's not because I wanted to. It's just all, you know, it's all part of
it. It's all for TV.
Yeah, I'm so
it's
sorry.
It's all dramatical.
I've had worse.
Yeah.
Whoa.
Well, I see you on Facebook as Brent Dickerson.
Yeah.
And whenever I go out and see you at cons, you are Brenda. And Brenda has kind of sunk in to me to who I want to call you as. So, Brenda, the show is all completely focused on you. Very intimate interview that we're going to do tonight. And this is the first time, really, that we're going to really get inside somebody's life and history in Austin, because you've been here for a very long time. You were born in 1960.
Yep.
And
whoa.
You're born in 1960. And that's not to say that you're old. It just means that you've been through so many different chapters in life, and you have a lot to share. You have a story to tell. So tell me about the beginnings when you were growing up. Tell me about the school that you went to and how you became Brenda.
Well, it didn't happen in elementary school.
Okay.
Why not?
I went through all 12 years of school in Plainview, Texas. So I only went to three schools, elementary school, one junior high, one high school.
Okay.
So you grew up in hardcore Texas, pretty much, you know.
Super Bible Belt.
Very Bible Belt, very, you know, they would measure our hair.
Mm-hmm.
And
right.
Watch
right.
your shirts, what you yep. wore.
Put a little Bible between you when you dance.
I mean,
I got
sent
Texas
home
is one of the
couple
only
of
states
times.
That still has the SWATs.
Yeah.
I mean,
oh.
You got SWATs when you were a kid?
Oh, yeah.
Did you get SWAT?
I got a lot of them.
Yeah. So did I.
Yeah, you
I think
said,
I set a record in the seventh grade.
Oh,
me too, man.
Oh, wow. So you said that you got sent home. What did you get sent home from school for?
The first time was probably about the seventh or eighth grade. That's when the Aladdin scene came out.
Yeah.
And I thought it'd be like, man, I'd like to dress like that. I would much rather dress like that than dress like Greg Brady.
Right, right.
But, hey, I mean, everything else feels softer than what Greg Brady's
exactly.
wearing.
But the school didn't like it, so I had to go home and change
into
normal clothes.
And your parents, what did they say about that?
They didn't know about that one.
Okay.
Well,
they do now.
Well, you kind of kept it away from. I mean, it's. I mean, you gotta imagine, Eddie. I mean, it's fucking West Texas in the middle of the '60s and '70s, dude.
Yeah, very true.
I mean, you're not gonna act like your own self in West Texas
it's
in the
conform,
middle of the desert. And
conform, right?
Yeah, oil and longhorns.
Yeah.
Steer queer.
Yeah. So tell me.
We were even a dry county. We didn't even have beer.
Oh, my
no
God.
Beer?
You are such
it was 40 miles to
child.
Buy beer.
Wow. So while you're there, you're going to school. You find out that you're a little bit different than everybody. You're a little bit further out there. What kind of music were you listening to when you're growing up?
Ooh.
I've been listening to Alice Cooper since I was 11.
Fuck yes.
The Love It to Death.
Yeah.
My cousin played it for me when I was 11 years old, and he's been my favorite ever since.
Yeah. I don't know if the camera can zoom in, because we got some Zombie Life splatter going across the screen. But
oh, look at that.
You can see the Flush the Fashion tattoo on Brenna's arm, and it's just amazing, dude.
Flush the Fashion.
You are iconic. And so how long ago did you get that tattoo?
The Alice Cooper, this one about 3 years ago. This one about a year and a half ago.
Okay.
And the David Bowie. I got the week
that's
he passed
my
away.
Guy yeah, right that, that was David the week that Bowie. He passed away.
That's
was,
my guy.
I was scheduled to get a tattoo already, and then when that happened, I like sent him another picture. I'm like, I know you got the other one ready, but can I change tattoos, and I'll get the other one later.
Yeah, he nailed and it. That
he did
one
a great
excellent.
Job.
Yeah, he did a really, really good job.
Are those your favorite or your most favorite tattoos? I mean, what is your favorite tattoo? I mean, I'm sure that you have a lot more, but what is your favorite tattoo?
No, that's all of them for now. I mean, I'm getting some more.
Yeah? Would you ever
the
have?
Alice, this one, I'm actually going to get only, this arm is going to be all Alice Cooper.
Okay.
Yeah. All everybody else will be on the other arm.
Now, oh, if you could be like one of those teenage chicks and have Alice Cooper sign that arm.
Ooh, that'd
be
awesome.
Would you have it tattooed?
Yeah.
That'd be awesome.
Fuck yes.
Have you ever got to meet Alice Cooper?
Actually, if you scroll way back in my Facebook feed, there's a picture of Alice Cooper choking me.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Choking
like
you
a
out.
Chicken?
That's awesome.
I got my picture made with him in San Antonio, like 1987.
Fuck
wow, yes. Dude.
Because everyone always says,
that's
well, you look so young
age.
In that picture. And I'm like, but I was young in 1987.
That's about when I started. I started thinking about shrooms in 87.
Oh, my God. Yeah. I was thinking about...
yeah.
You know, eating shrooms at your grandmother's house.
Yeah. Good times.
It was.
So as you're growing up, you realize that you're a little bit different and you want different things and you listen to a little bit different music. You weren't listening to the country music, I guess, that was on the radio where you grew up at. Yeah. What drove you to move to Austin? Of all places in the world, how did you end up here?
Well, we came here on vacation every year growing up.
Oh,
I had
really?
Relatives here, and I've always been a UT fan, so I always wanted to live here, but, you know, I waited till I got out of high school, and then by the time I got out of school, the locals in Plainview were kind of insistent that I move to another city.
Oh, so. Oh man.
That's how you told me.
Seemed like a good time to go.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And,
so you basically got removed from the town that you lived in and grew up in and loved and cared about.
Yep.
And ended up in Austin. Was it hard to make friends when you finally got here?
No, actually, when I got here, the first couple of trips downtown, I thought I had died and gone to heaven.
Yeah.
I got here during the heyday of Clubfoot and Raoul's and...
Wow, man.
Towards the end of the Armadillo World Headquarters.
What was the first show that just, like, blew your mind? Like, you were walking down 6th Street and first time, and you saw the lights and the people and all the action and stuff like that, and you walk into a club, and it's all smoky.
Yeah.
You could smell the beer on the floor, and then you see who?
I don't know if y'all have heard of them, but there was a band called the Judies.
Okay.
In the early 80s that I was... I probably saw him 20 times.
Rock and roll.
Yeah.
I'm
not sure what
man.
You would call them, but they had the strangest lyrics of any band I've ever listened to. And they used to do a song called Guyana Punch right after the Jim Jones thing. And they had a big thing of red Kool-Aid they would dump on the audience.
Oh,
we could
cool.
all drink it and then flop around and have spasms all over the floor.
That's cool.
And act kinda
like we were dying. Kind of sound like one of the churches I went to when I was growing up.
Yeah, we're not Mormon.
Yeah. No, that was. I think that was a Pentecostal. Not that there's anything wrong with Pentecostal. I'm just saying we did a whole lot of flipping around in that church. So you go to this band and you realize that you fit in really well inside Austin and you started making friends. How did you become the Brenda that you are today? When did you decide, you know what? Fuck it,
fuck
man.
Fuck everybody.
I'm just going to do it.
Fuck it all.
Because there's a lot of people that want to know. And I don't know if you realize what kind of icon you are in Austin, but as the season goes, there used to be an icon, and he was like half dressed, and he used to ride a bicycle or something like that.
Man. Yeah. Dude, if you don't know who Leslie is, then
Leslie,
you don't. Yeah. I mean,
right, right.
I used to like I was talking about earlier. I used to ride my bike down there, and I'd stay on 6th Street. And I would,
yeah.
Like as an 11-year, 12-year-old, I would ride my bike up and sit next to Leslie when he had his big sign up.
Right.
You know, and he'd paint everything, write everything he wanted to on cardboard. And I'd just sit next to him smoking cigarettes, fucking watching the people walk past and look at their faces.
That's
man.
Amazing. When did you realize that you were Brenda? That you could just do it here and nobody gave a shit?
Mid-80s. And, you know, the girlfriend I was living with at the time, she was kind of into it. She didn't seem to mind.
Yeah.
And... But I never really promoted it as Brenda. I mean, pretty much everywhere I went, that's it seemed like everyone was doing that in the 80s.
Right.
It wasn't really talked Big about.
Yeah.
Nobody seemed to give a shit.
So right.
I could go dress however I wanted and go wherever I wanted. And and nobody...
Did it turn more risque in the 90s? Like,
and
I
then
mean,
actually,
into
the
into fashion,
in the 90s, that same girlfriend kind of got... Burned out on, you know, I don't...
She started wearing flannel and banging her head.
I don't want to be going out with a girl all the time. So,
yeah.
Brenda kind of went on a hiatus. And yeah. I would dress like at, yeah. I would dress like at Halloween or maybe for certain shows where I knew... There's always been some shows you could go to where people kind of expect that.
Right,
but
right.
I didn't do it... it's actually just been about the last year that I just... I did it a few times, and then my friends seemed to like it, and then my main close circle of friends, I just said, listen, this is the way it's gonna be from now on.
Right. Now I've seen you in other outfits. You did you were a priest one time that I saw you on Facebook, and I've seen you on stage doing like not an exorcism, but
I had to drive the demons out of a friend of mine,
out of
everybody in the club.
Right.
That was my that was my part.
Yeah.
Yes.
And it was totally awesome, man.
You know, and with all the outrageous clothes I've worn on 6th Street, the Catholic priest scared people more than anything.
Oh,
I mean, is there
hello?
One
else
guy
that
literally jumped off
the
curb.
Catholic
he like
priest?
Because he was like asking me, "Are you a real priest?" And I was like, dude, if you got fucking demons bothering you, let me know. I'll kick his ass right here and now. That's the kind of priest I am.
That's the kind of priest I want, man, you know? Like, hey, just right here and now.
He just kind of silently walked away. I don't know if he was sure what really to think.
He disappeared into the pit of hell he came from.
Yeah.
Dun, dun, dun.
But you're doing these different events, right? And now you're on stage and people are handing you a microphone and you're doing all kinds of different stuff. Did you ever, growing up in Plano, did you ever see yourself becoming a literal icon of the music capital of the world?
No, I didn't.
Yeah.
I didn't even see it last
year.
Yeah. I just was like.
And we're announcing it
this
now.
This is what I want to do, so I'm going to do it. And you know, I'm too old now to give a rat's ass.
Fuck everybody.
I
told him, well, the thing is, never in my entire life have I given less of a fuck than I give right now.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
Well, and you know, and that's when you're going to be the most beautiful.
Right.
When
right,
you stand up and say, fuck the world, I'm going to be who I'm going to be.
I've had my moments.
And I don't care who you are.
Sometimes I wish
what
I had.
Think of me?
Sometimes I wish I had more moments. You've had your moments.
I have my moment every morning.
Yeah, you look in the mirror like, shut up.
I'm sorry I didn't say that.
Yeah. you've been in Austin from the beginning. You've seen politics change. You've seen neighborhoods and communities change. Are people more accepting of you now than ever before? As Austin moves towards, you know, half of Austin seems to be a very liberal city. The other side is kind of a weird... I want to say conservative, but it's almost like a dark, evil kind of...
Well, I mean, there's you know, it's not a dark, evil,
you know,
man.
I mean, they
rich
care...
And poor, you know, I mean, it's always been that
It's
way.
Like they care so much about if you wear a polo or if you don't wear a polo, you know...
Gentrification, man.
Yeah, it's you've seen the politics
most people
change.
Here in Austin, if they... from what I've experienced anyway, I mean, if they don't like it, they're not saying anything.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, there may have been one or two people. I had like two people have unfriended me on Facebook, but
oh, really?
And fuck those people.
But
Brenda's
you
made like 900 friends in just a few months.
Right.
Wow.
Right. And
we are actually looking into. I was talking to a couple of women that are friends of mine about doing a fan page just so I can go on there as Brent without being everybody on the planet wants to chat with me.
Right. Really? As Brenda.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, because you have...
I bet there's an actual Japanese vending machine with your panties in Tokyo.
Sell your panties.
It's probably, like, it's got your picture on it. Like,
totally.
Brenda Dickerson.
Dude, that's $1 million idea, man. That's yours now. You take that and run with it.
Trademark.
Yeah. But you've seen people change. You've seen the politics change. You've seen the religion change. How do you feel being in Austin? Or do you see yourself now that you're... You know, when you come out, you're Brenda, and you rock it like nobody I've ever seen before. But
Red Rock.
Are you thinking maybe growing out of Austin and becoming a national icon? Because on Facebook, and again, you might not realize it, but people see you as an icon of Austin. But not just Austin, because of how brave you are with what you do, and you just, you know, you say whatever you want to say. You don't give a fuck, really. And... people look up to that because they see peace in that in a weird way. Do you want to grow out of Austin and become a national icon?
I'm okay with it.
Yeah.
That wasn't my plan, but right now I am kind of I'm enjoying the ride.
We have your Brenda for president.
Brenda for president, yeah. Right here. Always.
Yeah. Mine's on my nipple, and yours is just above yours, which is weird.
I mean, I pulled it away from my heart.
Okay. Oh, very good. That, you know, you thought that one out. But I'm going to call you a national icon now. As a national icon,
How about a pioneer?
Yeah.
How about a pioneer?
Okay.
Okay, you are a pioneer for everybody. I mean, what would you tell people that didn't have... you know, the friends or the output that you had, you know, being able to, you know, just go to Austin or something like that. Like kids that are actually stuck in the fucking Midwest and they're like, I should be Brenda.
Yeah, actually, I do chat with people on Facebook that ask me stuff like that. And I try to tell them, I know you probably can't do in those towns what I can do here in Austin.
Right.
But you couldn't do what...
But you should have at least... Try. Everybody should have those few friends where you can... Hey, we're going to go watch movies and we're going to... You know what? I'm going to wear a skirt or a, you know, whatever it is they're wanting to wear.
Damn right.
I was close to my friends to begin with, but I'm even closer to them now.
It's more like family now.
I mean, they do... We do consider each other family.
Damn
especially
right.
A lot of the Austin Horror Society, all those people are
Blood Over Texas.
Those are my closest friends. That's where it all started. And Blood Over Texas has been great to me.
Yeah,
that was one of the first Frightmare I went to. I joined Blood Over Texas.
Frightmare is, goddamn, it's one of the greatest.
So awesome!
It's like a religious experience.
Yeah. Oh my god, no, so much fun.
Very cool. Very cool.
And it was really great. David Arquette came running up and took my picture up there last year. He took my picture and ran off.
Oh, really?
I wanted to chase him down. I said, dude, I need $30.
You wanted to chase David Arquette down? Yeah. I was trying to run away from Tara Reid.
Yeah.
What the fuck happened to Tara Reid?
But I think that you're doing great, man. I think that you have a whole lot to tell people and a whole lot that people can learn from you. I wanted to bump. We're almost half an hour into it real quick. But I wanted to bump into what you have to say. Let's pretend that you are Brenda the president. Now there's a whole lot of people that look up to you, and for the
Brenda super, for president
super duper conservative side of people that watch the
fuck
show
them.
Bless you, but you know,
I'm sorry, I sneezed.
I just want to consume tight.
Sorry.
There's a message that people need to know, you know. Whenever I do the show with Red Rum, people always ask us, well, how did you do this? And really for us, it's just, well, just go fucking do it, you know.
Well, it's talking to people. It's like, I don't put myself on any level. I want to know what's going on.
Yeah, just go do it.
Talk to you like we would do the same conversation if we were sitting on my couch drinking a few beers or...
Smoking a blunt.
Oh,
you know,
I don't smoke blunts.
Woo!
Or anything, you know. I mean, but you
never
know,
did a blunt with formaldehyde.
Yes, I did. Okay. At your grandmother's house, yeah. And I regretted it.
Well, you know, we grow up. We
your
grow
grandmother
up.
Took advantage of me. And
oh,
was...
that's what I was going to talk about.
Yeah. Oh, no. I was
going to talk about drugs and my grandmother. Let's talk about. Okay. No, we're going to talk about drugs for a minute. Okay. Now, I've had my fair share.
I've had my fair share.
growing up in the Midwest, it's people would think that a small town has nothing but innocent people, but I can tell you, growing up in Markham, Texas, is the highway between Mexico and Houston, and that's where all the drugs go to. Was there a lot of drugs in the town that you grew up?
Plainview was covered in them.
Covered in drugs.
Well,
we were kind of the biggest of all the tiny towns.
Yeah.
In the middle of like Lubbock and Amarillo and Clovis, New Mexico. Those were like the three big cities.
What was the big drug in your day?
Quaalude in the late 70s.
Oh, yeah.
That's what we did in school. Look at my hands off.
Look at his face. Look at how excited Red Rum got when you said Quaalude. I've never done Quaalude. I've never done Quaaludes, but
fill the cup.
You had a chapter in life to where you experienced being on the other side, right?
Yeah.
And alcohol and drugs and cigarettes and stuff, and some of us still battle with some of those things. Like, I'm having a hard time with cigarettes, like bad.
By the way, I'd like to say congratulations on 22 years of sobriety, man.
Yeah.
Like, that is fucking phenomenal.
I was getting to that. You stole my thunder, goddammit.
I'm sorry.
But it is quite a phenomenal feat, man.
Seriously.
Did you wake up one morning and be like, man, I am fucking done. I just can't do it anymore. How did it happen for you?
Well, that morning I actually woke up in a wood pile.
Okay.
With my dog looking at me funny. Like,
shit.
His face is
funny. Why are we sleeping out here in the wood pile?
Yeah.
As opposed to, we got a perfectly good bed and pillows and everything over there in the house.
But, yeah.
And I had, for a couple of months at that time, been kind of going back and forth as to whether, you know, there's that point where, you know, I don't want to do it no more, but I'd done it for so long at the time.
Was it just alcohol? I mean, was it everything straight across the board?
Nah, I quit everything at once.
Really?
Alcohol, Valium.
Like cold turkey, everything. You were just like, fuck it all.
We eat all of it.
Me and Brenda were out.
So, weed and everything. You just quit.
God damn.
Did you have like a reaction to that? Did people ask you, you know, what's going on? Did you get super depressed? Is that when you decided that you had to move out of town and move to
Austin?
Move
when you became
sober. I'd been here in Austin a long time when that happened.
Oh, okay,
I'd been here like 14 years.
Okay, so I was saying there's no drugs at all in Austin.
Like you said, he, you know, I mean, she moved here in 80.
Yeah,
22 years.
This was 1994.
Woo! I graduated in 92.
Quite a run there.
And that is quite a run, man. So you woke up, decided to be sober.
So what was coke like in the 80s?
It was excellent.
Yeah. There you go, man. Yeah. Time travel to the 80s, motherfucker.
I'm just going to be falling asleep with coke in the 80s.
What did you turn to, man? If you don't have drugs, which is half of somebody's personality, and you can ask any...
Especially in this field. I mean, it's just...
Rock and roll,
alcohol,
man.
Drugs.
What did you do without it?
Well, I wasn't. Like I say, I had gotten involved in the recovery community here locally.
Okay.
And I know I had other people that I would talk to about it. I know, when I would find out there are people that actually get sober, which was.
I
news
gotta
to
say
me.
Those stockings hold some big fucking balls.
Yeah. Yeah.
I'm sorry because I mean,
and you guys,
22 years sober. In this environment, especially starting in the 80s, like, I mean, you should have a silver plaque.
No, you should have trophies.
Every AA fucking meeting
every year,
Austin.
You should have, like, a trophy at your house.
Like, they should have, like, instead of handing out, you know, yearly chips,
yeah,
they should hand out 20-year fucking chips with your face on them.
That'd be awesome. But again, everybody, Brenda for president. I'm just saying, you know, throwing it out there because that's who I'm going to write on my ballot because I'm not
right.
I'm not down with anybody.
Remember, I can be president and first lady. I'll cover both jobs.
All in one and take both salaries.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
President and first lady. Whenever you started dressing as Brenda in Austin and you're going to all these different places, people start to come to you and ask you, what? Can you do announcing for me? Can you come to this event? Are you like a some kind of entertainment person?
Well, a lot of that just, I mean, I'm friends with a lot of the people that do that. And a lot of them just happen like spur of the moment. Now, the Catholic priest, I don't know if y'all have ever seen I Rock Die. He's a local musician, friend of mine. But he had asked me, he's like, I want you
the devil eyes.
Yeah, I'd like you to come on stage and do this. And he told me what it was. So I was like, sure, what the hell?
Were you nervous?
No.
No? You don't have that, do you?
No.
No.
Not anymore. What have I got to lose?
Right.
I'm a huge fan of your fucking vest. Like, I'm a huge fan. Like, when I was growing up in the 80s here in Austin, I had my fucking jean jacket, and I was sewing on fucking patches that I could get and stuff like that. Where did you get this? I mean, I love the Social D, and I mean, the back of your fucking
leopard print collar. Shit, dude.
I mean, really, dude?
Shit, man.
The barbed wire
dolls. I mean, it's almost like a...
Their lead singer.
It's like a cop shirt with shit on it.
Isis Queen is her name.
Yes!
Oh, okay.
Singer from Barbed Wire Dolls. She actually made this for me.
Isis Queen.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Wow,
she made this shirt.
Barbed Wire Dolls.
I got it from her in San Antonio a couple of years ago.
They're so fucking hot.
That is cool.
They are. She's great.
I did want to ask, though, now he brought up the vest. Do you have somebody that designs your outfits? Because I've seen you with green hair, blue hair, pink hair, black hair. And I've even seen one, it's like kind of like a mohawk type, but that might have been real hair, but I'm not sure.
Yeah, mohawk, and that's my actual hair.
Oh, yeah, okay, cool.
What's left of it.
Yeah, I only have 12 left anyway, and when I put them up in a mohawk.
Yeah, but you look like Bozo the Clown with your...
I know.
I've got like the cul-de-sac.
Yeah, throw the white ball over on this end.
Do you have a clothing design?
A lot of help with the makeup, but the clothes, that's all me.
Yeah.
I pick out the outfits.
So you took some lady stockings and cut the ends off of them, kept the tops, and then made some gloves.
Is that how it goes down, or can you buy those?
No,
at the Madonna's?
The gloves came with another. They're part of another outfit.
Very
the gloves
nice.
Came with it.
Very
that
nice.
Is awesome.
So but I have made a couple of gloves out of shirts that have a sleeve about here.
Yeah, yeah.
And I would cut them jagged up here, and then take that part of the sleeve down here and loop it around.
Okay.
Put something
God damn.
Over it.
That's the creativity, man.
You got some fucking guns.
I know,
man.
Dude. I
swear to God, we need to have like a fucking arm wrestling competition or something like that.
And have you just smash people in the face.
Seriously.
Boom,
just,
motherfucker.
Like bring your big old fucking retard buff dudes, you know, like
be
sorority
awesome.
Guys and be like, yeah, you're going to arm wrestle her.
Yeah. Bam. But speaking of guns and everything, you are employed, and you have a job. Are you done with that job?
No, I'm still working there.
You're still working there. Okay. Do you ever go to work as Brenda?
No. We have a uniform I have to wear.
Okay.
And I wouldn't, you know, I play with chainsaws and stuff during the day. I wouldn't want to wear none of my nice clothes anyway.
Wow,
so
you're
a tree trimmer.
I sweat too much.
What do you do? What chainsaws?
I do pest control.
Okay.
I know my poisons.
Yeah, exactly.
And
that explains all.
I can sharpen a chainsaw blade.
That's all I need to know.
Beyond anyone else y'all can think of. I
really?
Can make that blade sharp.
Wow, man. I got some work for you.
Keep that in mind if you ever want to comment about you don't like something I wear.
Yeah, yeah. And I've got some people to get rid of, too, so I'll be seeing you.
Circumcision.
The coolest thing about it, man, is that you're able to do both consistently. So you can go to work and you got your button-up uniform, and do people know that you have this incredible second life that you go do, or do you have people from work that are fans of your Facebook page?
Some of the other maintenance guys are, but they're the ones that go to listen to the same kind of music I do.
Oh yeah,
go to those shows.
I mean, it's two separate lives.
Yeah.
I mean, are you going through the regular life as the norms and shit like that, and just kind of with a smile on the inside, like, yeah, I could just rape this shit.
Yeah. Yeah.
You
every
know,
day.
But you're like
every day,
you know,
all day,
all
shit.
Like totally calm, like, yeah, no, I'll spray this, I'll cut that tree. No problem.
I remember while we were in San Antonio, you came to me and you said something about you went to a store out of town or something where people weren't used to seeing people at your caliber, I'll say. How often does that happen to where people just take a moment and stand and stare at you? Does that make you uncomfortable at all?
No, I love it.
Yeah.
I thrive on it.
Yeah.
Yes.
And, you know, on our way to Frightmare last year,
yeah,
up in Dallas, and then there was eight of us. We had like a little convoy of cars, and we got dressed like 7 a.m. and all headed for Dallas, and I had on a very skimpy nurse outfit.
Skimpy, explain.
Very
skimpy.
Hot.
Cleavage skimpy.
Ass skimpy. Yeah,
package
covered
skimpy.
Here, and then it has a little strip here, and then covers a little bit.
Okay, okay, okay. Was that the pink hair?
And I think I wore the red hair with that, yeah.
Okay, okay. I was close. So I'm checking you out, man. I'm checking
but
you out.
We stopped in Waco and went to Freddy's Burgers.
Mm-hmm.
And, I mean, that's like everyone in the place just shut up when we walked in. It was like, it got totally quiet.
Yeah, well, what the fuck are they going to say? They can't say nothing. I mean, look at you.
And, like, the part that's funny to me is kids, like, seem really fascinated with it. Kids will, you know, I mean, they're going to stare, and they want to look, and they want to say something, and this. This one girl was like, I don't even know what she was going to say. She just started to say something, and she was pointing, and her mom was like, don't say anything.
Don't look at it. Don't
she was
look
just
at
like,
him.
Eat your food.
Well, see, that's a great
like
thing
about
kids.
Like looking at you is going to give them cooties.
So I just waved at them. You know,
that's the great thing about
my
kids,
hamburger.
Man, is that they have no recollections or any kind of, you know, built-up stuff. You
yeah.
know? They're just like, what are you? Tell me.
Yeah,
what's
yeah,
going
yeah.
on?
Yeah, inspiring
yeah,
is what
great.
I call it.
Yeah.
Kids are great. Do you ever have events to where you have to talk to people about what you do? Like, do people ever come up to you and say, dude,
what do you mean?
What's your deal?
What
like,
does
what?
She do?
Yeah.
What is she
do? Well, dude, sometimes people ask me, you know, what is this, a special occasion?
Mm-hmm.
And I'm like, you know, yeah, it's Tuesday.
Yeah.
Praise
the Lord.
I mean,
silk
just,
feels really good against
my nuts. Hallelujah. Julia.
And, but,
never
at Frightmare last year, and one of the biggest comments I get, and it's nearly always, sometimes from guys, but a lot of women will come up and I'm like, they want to know like how you do it. Like you just walked into this hotel like you own the place.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, I've had two.
I've got a room here.
Frightmares that
I do own it for right now.
Yeah. It's mine.
I've had two girlfriends at Frightmare that we weren't even talking to you, hanging out, and they just see you and they're like, "Damn."
Yeah. Working it. Working
holy
it.
Shit.
It'd be funny though if a guy came up to you, you know. And his girlfriend doesn't see to ask you questions. Like, you ever been picked up?
That's happened before.
Yeah.
You know? You ever been picked up?
A few times.
Yeah. That's cool.
How about a sorority guy or a fraternity guy? Like, he walked up to you and he's like, hey, bro.
Yeah.
You know, and you can see his eyes are twisted. And, you know, he's been there for 3 hours on 6th Street.
Have you done this? Have you hit on Brenda?
Three times.
Okay.
Sorry, I'm just trying to hash some old shit. I'm just trying to
bring
figure
it
out my past.
It's a little flappy old laundry there. Whenever you go do events, though, everybody loves you. Everybody receives you really, really well here in Austin. Are you going to be in a band? Are you going to be the front singer of a band? Because that's how I see you. I see you on the Kiss level with the shoes and the fishnets. And, you know, I mean, you just working it, dude.
Don't compare to, you know,
Gene Simmons.
I mean, don't compare to Gene Simmons,
come on,
man.
I almost wore the Ace Frehley outfit up here.
Thank you.
I mean,
that's what I was saying. Like, no Gene Simmons.
Okay. Is that what you want?
Gene is a dick.
That's what I heard. I don't know. I've never met him.
This wasn't what I planned, but people have talked to me about it lately. I mean, I did rehearse some with some friends of mine. I was just going to do a song. I mean, just one song with them.
okay.
of my choosing.
Yeah.
An Alice Cooper song, of course. There's a band here that has talked to me about coming out as a.
Who are they?
Doing there's a Pretties for You, which okay. is a local Alice Cooper cover band.
Pretties for You?
Which y'all can see at the Dirty Dog Sunday. They're just
Hell
getting
yeah.
started.
Dirty Dog on but, Sunday?
Yeah.
What time?
6 o'clock.
Six
and
o'clock.
There'll be like five bands.
Fuck yeah.
And it's a benefit for the flood victims of Baton Rouge.
Oh, okay.
No shit.
Wow.
That's a good
good reason to come out and rock and roll with the rest of us.
And it's like old school punk kind of, you know.
And
Alice Cooper.
It's going to be some Alice Cooper music.
Fuck
so
yes.
How's the lead, how's the lead singer for that?
Haven't met her yet.
Okay.
Like I say, I've seen their pictures. I proposed to the whole band.
Oh, did you?
When
you
I found
just
their page.
The whole band to
I just,
get married?
Yeah, I said, would y'all marry me?
Fuck yes. not just one, but
yeah,
all four of you.
That's awesome.
The whole
man.
Band.
So you guys can relate because you're Mormon.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm. I like to get married to multiple people at the same time,
yeah,
too.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So.
But I'm
now,
hoping for a chance to maybe go, not to sing, but for those of you who know Alice Cooper, you know his wife mm-hmm. plays the evil nurse.
Yeah.
Yes.
I'm hoping to do the evil nurse because I actually, when we went to the Alice Cooper show recently,
so we need to get you
I dressed
riding crop.
Just like her. You could,
yeah.
Oh, I have one of those.
I got
a couple of paddles.
I got a buddy.
Why didn't I think of that?
I'll send some audio to you. I got a buddy in Salt Lake right now who had, this is actually
Pete. Dirty Pete!
Yeah, Pete had a show with Alice Cooper for about a year in Arizona. Some of the best audio I've ever heard. But saying that you're going to move into the band and do the whole rock star thing, that is a living dream for anybody that wants to be in Austin. That's a lot of reason why people move to Austin so they can get into the music scene.
Yeah.
And it's
also,
what they need is Brenda. That's what they need. How do you
an icon?
Yeah, they need to be an icon. And do you sign your name as Brenda sometimes whenever you do autographs and stuff?
I haven't, but
you're going to.
I do get.
Can I get a pen in
like
here? Because I'm gonna get
the Frightmare stuff. When I have
Sharpie!
People write me autographs, I do. You know, they always ask, "Who do you want to make this out to?"
Yeah.
And for the last couple of years, I've been signing. They autograph it to Brenda.
Yeah, dude.
So all my posters at my
well,
house.
Well, tonight,
to Brenda.
If you haven't given your first autograph, you've never given an autograph. Tonight is gonna happen.
We're gonna sign. We're gonna have Brenda sign 10 stickers, 10 Zombie Life TV stickers.
Yes,
and
yes.
we will give them out to special people mm-hmm. to pass out. If we find them on the street,
yeah,
you get yeah. a special prize.
Oh, we gotta say, well, thank you guys so much for bringing the Sharpies to us, Brenda. You are now a living, breathing icon of Austin. These two pins are very special because. They're the first pens that are going to have your signature on something, and I'm going to have you sign everything besides, you know, the old Willie. Everything else is good game.
You can sign the old Willie.
Sign the old Willie.
We
have about 15 minutes left, and the show is a zombie show. I want to thank you
yeah.
for being on in the first place because you are special to me. I think that you're amazing, and what you do for the community is just out there and wild, man. Very, very cool.
Thank you.
I want to get into how dark your mind gets. I want to know about your nightmares.
You sure about that?
I want to know about your daydreams. I want to know about the hot seat, which we'll get into in about, you know, I don't know, 7 more minutes. But tell me about your dreams. What kind of dreams do you have? Do you fly? Do you fight demons?
Is it Martha Stewart in prison?
but I do have visions of flying.
You do?
Yeah, that's always going to be. I really would like to fly.
Yeah.
I always have visions of
without a plane.
Yes. Well, they got that zero gravity. Not zero gravity. It's like a big ass fan underneath you.
Ice guy.
Dude, I'd love to go flying with you there, man. Just to say that I held hands with Brenda, if anything.
Yeah, but what if one of you is so scared that you actually piss your pants and everything just flies up in your
It's
face.
All for the moment.
Yeah. Well, I won't be
I
wearing pants.
So yeah.
That won't be
See,
a problem.
That's what I'm saying.
I'm wearing
you
a
know,
skirt.
It's like right above that yeah. Willy Wonka fucking fan.
Yeah. yeah. So no real dreams right now to speak of, but when you think about Halloween, you think about dressing up as a Halloween character, who's your go-to? Because there's a lot of people that just want to know, because you've done it all, you know, as far as dressing up and stuff. Where do you, what's your go-to for Halloween?
Well, last couple of years, so I like combined looks. Like
okay.
Last year, you know, and I can, any of this stuff, we can scroll back on Facebook and find them. But I did like an Alice Cooper, Ace Frehley, Lady Gaga mix.
Oh, no shit.
So you've always been about, you know, kind of.
And then I love the comments from people that, because they'll guess like part of it. And it's a.
And.
Except for the thing about the Ace Frehley outfit, mm-hmm. is I've had about a half a dozen people come up and say, "All right, Power Rangers." And
I just, oh my God.
I just want to smack them, you know? Like,
seriously.
No!
You should. You should smack them and then step on them with your platform.
Yeah, that'd be awesome. That's a good YouTube video right there.
Yes. But, I mean, with all these bands and influence and stuff like that, especially with Halloween, and I mean, I know, like, it's going to be kind of shock 'em.
Yeah.
But, I mean, what do you love to do for Halloween? Seriously.
And what shocks you?
I mean, do you, like, sit there and you're like, I am Brenda, but then Halloween comes along and you're sitting in your apartment.
I'm Jack Skellington. What the fuck? What just happened?
To little kids or something?
No, I don't stay at home. Hardly ever. I mean,
right.
I shower there and sleep, take naps off and on.
Yeah.
And, you know, play with my...
I'd love to live in your apartment.
I have a new puppy named Karloff.
Aww.
I like to go home and play with
cool.
him.
Are you a big reader?
No, but if I am at home, I'll watch... I mean, I don't even have cable or nothing. I'll watch... I got hundreds of horror DVDs.
Yeah.
Public access.
The old
so
stuff.
You just pull out old school stuff and
I
just
got,
watch it.
I got so many movies from the 20s,
30s,
40s, and 50s.
Movie?
Ooh, that's a good question. Favorite horror movie all time.
I mean, if you're sitting at home in your garters, stockings, you know, feeling good, balls hanging out, like, yeah.
Fuck yeah.
I'm going to pick this movie.
Yeah.
What is
I'm
it?
I'm a huge fan of Creature from the Black Lagoon.
Oh,
dude.
I love you.
Dude, that was fucking awesome,
man. Oh, my
man.
God,
Creature
dude.
From the Black Lagoon.
Especially when he comes out, like.
It just thrilled me to death when I, you know, they.
Yes.
One of the,
yes.
the guys that was the creature was at Frightmare 2 years ago.
Oh, yeah.
And the woman that played in the movie. Mm-hmm. You know, they're both in their 80s, but they were so awesome when I met them.
Yep.
And
fantastic.
Got their autographs.
Yep.
It was really cool to meet him. I mean, I got bought the Creature from the Black Lagoon shirt and everything, and those pictures are on there too. Because I actually, Ace Frehley was there that year, so I did the Ace Frehley face, but I did it in green.
Yeah.
Because people had asked me about it, you know, what the hell is that? And I'm like, well, this is Ace Frehley from the Black Lagoon.
Duh.
So now we have
Can't
to get
you tell?
Gene Simmons on.
I know. Now
we have
get
to get
Gene.
And Ace, so Brenda can hang out with them.
We're going to bump into our hot seat questions for the night. And this is the last segment.
Hardcore shit right here.
And we will not torture you any longer.
Sorry.
Although I could
have to take it.
Dude, I could have you sit here and talk to you all night, man. I mean, there's so many, you know, everything from politics.
Oh, just
to
ask a hot
religion.
Queef. Hot seat
hot
question.
Queef questions.
Hot queef questions.
You said
hot queef,
queef questions. Okay, hot seat. Do you believe in Bigfoot?
No.
At all? There's no way.
You don't think there's like a primate wandering?
Like me?
No,
like a knuckle dragon?
I think it's a giant hairy redneck from Oklahoma.
I agree with that.
Yeah.
And that obviously explains your plain view growing up. What about, man, I mean... You've had to have been out there and like laying on the beach in Corpus Christi or Matagorda after fucking partying all night in Austin
naked.
Taking a fucking swooping trip to the coast.
Yeah.
And you're like laying up there and you see a UFO. Have you ever seen a UFO?
I've thought I did aliens? A time or two. Absolutely.
Yeah?
Fuck yes.
Yes.
Why?
Just from everything I read and all the way back to the old cave drawings you see, where they had flying saucers on the cave wall.
That's true.
I think it's pretty fucking arrogant for us to think, no, we're it. This is it.
Yeah.
Yeah. We're the only people in the entire universe.
Pretty pompous.
Ever.
We are the ultimate in intelligence. That's why we got
ever.
Two bozos running for president.
Yeah. Oh, my God. Did you just see the vice presidential debate?
I can't even watch it. I watched
it was literally just two dicks.
I was getting sick at my stomach after less than 5 minutes. So I had to go back to my room.
Cross the street.
Where's my goddamn clicker?
I went back to playing with my puppies.
Puppies is code word.
Karloff
right?
is much more entertaining than they are.
What do we have? 4 or 5 minutes? Okay. Do you think you've ever talked to an alien before? And mistaken him for a human being?
I could have in the 80s. Let's say there's
good drugs.
The
80s
were the 80s were so foggy to begin with.
Yeah, yeah.
And I never was really sure what was going on.
What do you think about mutants, man? like actually people that have grown up and have different abilities than everybody else. I mean, just regular people that you've met. I mean, do you think that mutants exist?
Think there's somebody that can fly?
Yes.
There's got to be somebody that can fly, right? I think
but
so.
I mean, you've met people that have different abilities than everybody else, and you're like, holy shit, that person is different.
Yeah, I'm always impressed.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes. She believes in mutants.
Final question. You ready?
Ready.
Before you die, do you think that zombies are going to walk the earth?
I hope so.
Oh,
I plan to be one.
Really?
Oh, you plan to be one?
Hell yeah.
A zombie? I would never be able to kill you.
Dude, I think you're the first person that ever said that on the show.
I just like poke you with the stick.
I'm
going to
be the sexiest cross-dressed zombie that ever existed.
Yeah, keep dressing you up.
You know what, dude?
I'm going to look so good that they're not going to want to shoot me in the head.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. I'm like,
And this is a true story, man. I wrote about you in my first book, because I have a book.
Yep.
Before I knew who you were, I wrote about a cross-dressing zombie that fucking just beat everybody's ass.
Yep.
And I did, right?
Yes, you did.
Yeah, before I knew who you were, I wrote about a cross-dressing.
You have to read the books, people.
And his outfit is strangely like yours, which is cool and disturbing at the same time. It's just very, very cool, man.
Yeah, it's actually really surreal. He wrote about, you know, with you and stuff like that. And there was also parts of, like, me, Jeffrey in the book that weren't before we even met.
Yeah. Very, very, very cool stuff, man.
That doesn't mean that Mormons are right.
I want you to know, man. I just want you to know that we appreciate you, man, and what you're doing for Austin, everything that you're doing. Don't stop. Because
it's very, seriously, please.
No one enjoying it more than I am.
Yeah.
I think there's probably a few people that are.
Quite a following.
Well, maybe not, but you know, I mean.
Quite a following.
That's okay.
Where can people find you on social media?
It's on Facebook right now.
Right now?
Just find it.
And you're working on the Twitter.
Starting to sound like I need
to. Everyone's just find
been him. Bugging me about it lately.
Dude, you need to do more. You would have ultimate fans. You need a Brenda website. You need to have like a Brenda talks.
So. I think the people. I don't think she needs a website. I don't think she needs a talk show or anything like that. I think people need to get out there, put their fucking feet on the ground, get out in the clubs,
get their ass out of the house.
Yeah.
You know, and go up to her and talk to her.
They come out to the bar, I'll dance with them.
Exactly.
There you go.
Buy you a water.
My favorite
boots, man, are
the furry ones. Those are badass. Remember, because I texted you on Facebook, I said, where's the boots? Remember that?
Yeah, well, all the different colored wigs I have, I got the fuzzies to match them.
Yeah.
Well, I brought you a tank top. It's actually in my trunk. It says red, white, and wasted.
Very cool. I thought you were going to say it was the fishnet one from like.
No, it's a tank top. You know, red, white, and wasted.
Awesome. Awesome. Well, that's about going to tie up our show this week. Brenda, thank you so much for coming to the show. You are an awesome icon.
Thank you for having me.
I love you to death, dude. You are an amazing, amazing person.
Oh, my God.
We got 1 minute left. Red Rum, we've got a whole lot of things going on. We've got a few podcasts that are going to come out.
Yes.
That I've been saving them. People in the podcast world are like, what the fuck, dude?
You know? They can kind of wait and suck it.
Yeah, well, it's going to be a good sucking.
It's October,
man. It's a good sucking.
It's October.
There's a whole lot of shit going on. Please go find us on fanboytv.com, Zombie Life TV, and ZombieLifePodcast.com. October 28th through the 30th, we're going to be with Fanboy out at Mission Air Soft for
Texas
Terror Challenge. You're going to be able to actually meet Paul Fiero, who's put the whole thing on. It's actually a very, very cool event, and I hope to see you there.
Not
and everybody
only Paul
else.
Fiero, but you're actually going to be immersed in the frequency
yes.
world,
yes.
So, which is going to be really fucking awesome.
Very,
you
very cool.
You get to meet Eddie Rotten himself.
Ooh. Ooh. For more information ooh. About frequency, please go to our website, zineblogpodcast.com. My books are there. If you go to missionairsoft.com, that's where the freak show. I'm going to call it a freak show.
Yeah.
Desolation Manor's putting on Texas Terror Challenge. All that takes place inside my book. Paul Fiero liked the book, and he turned it into a haunt. So thank you guys so much for coming out. As always, kill them all, kill them all, kill them all, kill them all.
Prophets say, strange sounds will come from our skies. Some will call it the second coming. Our ability to lead, our morality, our humanity will disappear. Our hunger will be for flesh. Our souls will be forgotten. 3 days of hell on earth. And you are the chosen one. Do you accept the challenge? Details at TexasTerrorChallenge.com. Experience.